What's up everybody, welcome back to Kagzi Gaming for a new episode of TL13 War and Legend League base reviews. For today, a great CWL TH13 base, so we will check it out. If you want to support the channel or you want to see custom pro built bases with the links, check the channel membership out now. If you're new to the channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button, turn the bell for all notifications so you won't miss any base in the future. Leave a like and leave a comment. So let's talk about the base. This is the base. I really like the design. It's a great trophy base as well. You can see the Eagle Artillery is in the middle. Two scatter shots are spread around, so it will be hard to get them. Let's see the battle log. This is the battle log. Nobody 3-starred. It was tested on 5,400 trophies, maybe even more. So let's have a look on some replays. I'm using it in the CWL. On the last one, it did really nice. So let's pick a replay. Let's see what do we have. Let's start with this one. 5 healers, 7 yetis, 8 bowlers, the 4 earthquake with jump spell. Let's see what is plan. As you can see, 2 islands on the base with the single infernos spread around. Usually I prefer the single infernos, not the multi. Starting with the 4 earthquake spells on the clan castle. So maybe he will start from the bottom or he wants to take the town hall first. But he have 4 healers, 5 healers. So he will need to do a queen or a grand warden walk. So the king from the right taking out the royal champion. And yeah, he's gonna start from the top. Adding the grand warden. Now all the yetis. Where are the bowlers? Still didn't deploy them. They need to take the ice golems now. Okay, they're attacking the town hall. Easy takedown. Securing the first star with 13%. Grand Warden ability, not sure it was necessary. Now they are pretty much, they're not stuck. He opened it with the EQ. Needs to take the scatter shots pretty fast. Now using a jump spell. Let's see if the Yetimites can take it. Yeah, very nice. Now the Inferno will take at least one or two Yetis. Yeah, that's very good. Still got a queen ability. Saving one baby dragon, probably for the cleanup later. Royal Champion can't survive. Another super wall breaker. Wants to help the queen. Now she will need to use the ability if he wants her to survive, yeah. But the Grand Warden won't survive it. Also the Queen. And see ya. Now the baby dragon with a few archers for 30 seconds. It will be low percentage. Nice try though. Let's see, okay. Took only one archer, but now the archer tower will finish the baby dragon. So it will be 65%, 2 stars. Nicely done. Let's watch the next replay. So same spells, this time using super giants. 9 of them, with the witches, 12 bowlers and 4 healers. Starting from the same place, put the jump spell there. Few super giants, 2 on each side, using the siege barracks here. Yeah, the Inferno will finish the P.E.K.K.A. if she will get closer. So not the smartest idea, yeah. Not the Inferno, but the X-Bows, so either way the P.E.K.K.A. couldn't survive it. Now the World Champion is taking out the giants, starting with all of them. Let's see if they can take the town hall, using a lot there. Rage, pretty much missed with the rage most of his army. Definitely easy takedown on the town hall with the queen using the Grand Warden ability. Not even close to the scatter shots there. They're still stuck there. Royal champion can't survive. King is pushing, needs to use the king ability. Using the king ability will help him take down the scatter shots pretty fast. Queen took the right one. Finished with the tornado trap. Got loads of skeletons there. Yeah, the wizard tower will take them all. So only the queen with the grand warden. Got the queen ability. Yeah, but she can't survive. Especially with those infernos. Needs to use the queen ability. Not sure why he's waiting. So we let it did automatically. And goodbye to the queen. The inferno will finish the grand warden and it will be 63%. 2 stars. Another great defense. Now let's watch the last one. This time it's 6 yetis, 4 healers, 5 witches. Looks like... oh, it was the lightning spells with the one earthquake. So we took down the clan castle. Starting with all of them without funneling. Not the best idea. Using the Grand Warden ability way too early. Didn't even defend against anything. And he took the damage from the Giga Bomb. So he got only one freeze and one rage spell left. And now they are pretty much stuck outside. They will need to get the walls one by one. And now I think the scatter shot will finish all the Yetis there. Let's see. Yeah, they are not too close. One more hit. Probably the Yeti mites will finish it. Yeah. Nice, the Inferno took the Royal Champion. Queen used their ability. I'm really surprised he managed to take 60%. Because he did it very, very poorly. That's the problem when you're attacking with lots of Yetis. The Yeti mites taking a lot and they're doing serious damage to the defenses. Taking that Inferno, nice. Or no? No, they're attacking the skeletons. Saved by the bell, but now the Yeti mites will finish it. Last Yeti. Now the Grand Warden, let's see if he can take the Eagle Artillery before it will end. Maybe one more hit. Yeah, 76%, 2 stars. Very nice. Thank you very much for watching. That was the base for today, a CWL TH13 base. Also good for wars and for trophy pushing. So thank you very much for watching and I will see you on the next of Clash of Clans video. See ya!